23rd of September 1997, and Pop 001 is making its final approach into Sarajevo International Airport. Tonight's concert will be the 56th on U2's Pop Mart World Tour, but even by the standards of a show that includes the world's largest TV screen and a 40-foot-high mirrorball lemon, tonight's date will be an unusual one. The rest of the Pop Mart Tour was organised in 1997, but this show was arranged before then. 4 years before, on the evening of July the 3rd, 1993. We need to understand what was going on back then.
Thank you for joining us live on the air.
My pleasure.
The band were in the middle of the Europa leg of the Zoo TV tour, a hyperactive assault of a rock show that had seen U2 completely reinvent themselves, seeming to wave goodbye to the worthy but worried foursome that had conquered the world with a bare stage, three chords and the truth. The U2 that strutted in front of the giant screens of Zoo TV was a very different animal. The message, however well disguised, was the same, but the medium was different. This was the 90s, the age of CNN, the news live and on call 24/7. Watch me, the channel yelled out, I'll tell you things all day. But in a world of 24-hour news coverage, it quietly came to pass that the news needed to be more than just news. The news also had to be entertainment, and if it wasn't entertaining, it could not by definition be news at all. But at least there was lots of it. Total media overload, in fact. And this was the world that first Zoo TV and then Zooropa set out to surf and channel hop. This was the great contradiction at whose heart the band sat, holding up a mirror to it all, smiling and pointing, but definitely not preaching.
That's all, folks!
And then along came Bill Carter.
Heart to you, I love you, I love Sarajevo.
Metal.
Bill Carter was an American aid worker in the besieged city of Sarajevo.
Go, 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 go! Get it! You on?
By mid-1993, the siege of Sarajevo, in fact the whole awfulness of the fracture of Yugoslavia, was no longer making the news. Out of sight, being out of mind, terrible atrocities were happening on a daily basis, while the rest of the world stood idly by.
I don't like the looks of this in here.
We didn't know about them. How could we care? With no great mission in mind, other than to maybe convince the band to tape a message of support to bring back to his Bosnian friends, Bill smuggled himself out of Sarajevo, and far more impressively, into the band's enclosure backstage in Verona. As a result of that short meeting, Zoo TV, the television station that didn't broadcast, got decidedly and uncomfortably real.
It's obscene that we have to beam you into a rock and roll show, and that in with our fantasy of Zoo TV, we have your reality.
None of this had any place in the middle of a rock show, but the band reasoned, if they didn't put it there, where would it go? If they didn't show it, who would? The broadcast from Sarajevo, ordinary people given a voice by Bill and the band, lasted from Bologna through to Wembley. And while the messages were by times moving,
mia cara Mirica,
and by times awful,
what do you really do for us? Excuse me, I think nothing.
They were always awkward, and the show always suffered.
2 years ago, we were living like old teenagers, listening to music, going out. We have schools, friends, plans for a future. Now, we have shells, we have screams of children. Our schools are burned down. We'll never see many of our friends. They are gone forever.
After 18 months of glorious irony, the critics were delighted to point out that at the first opportunity, the band had jumped back up on that soapbox and started to preach.
Goodbye, Sarajevo.
But it made the news, and the silence was broken.